Free at noon. How are you? Hope you're having a great day today. My name is Natalie Hemby. We are so excited to play for you today here in Nashville, Tennessee at The Cabin, coming to you live. For those of you who might not know who I am, well, I know they have really fancy guests on here. Billy Idol has played, and if you're asking yourself, what does Billy Idol and Natalie Hemby have in common? And the answer is really nothing. So if I drink enough, I will sing Rock the Cradle of Love, at a wedding. So, but anyways, I am from Nashville, Tennessee. I'm a singer-songwriter. I've written songs for a lot of country artists, such as Miranda Lambert, Kacey Musgraves, and actually the Osborne Brothers, who are really good friends of mine. And I'm putting out a record October 8th, and we're going to play some songs from that record. And some of the co-writers you'll know on this. And this first song we're going to play for you is the actual title track of my record called Pins and Needles. And I wrote this with the Brothers Osborne a long time ago, actually. It's probably been over 10 years ago. And we wrote it for them, but you know what? It didn't work out for them. And I was like, that song was sitting around. I was like, hey, do you mind me having this song for my record? And they're like, absolutely. So this is the first song off that we're going to play you off Pins and Needles, and it's called Pins and Needles. Give it up, don't try. Here's what I tell myself, but it's like running away from rain in the desert. Stumbled up, blacked out. I don't know how hard I felt, but I've been crawling to you ever since we've been together. Much. I can hear your applause all over the world. We have people tuning in from Antarctica. I'm just kidding. no, it's live streams are fun, but they're also weird, you know. But I really do feel the applause deep down. So I'm pretty sure maybe my mom is watching too. Hello to my mom. So Anyways, I'm gonna move right along, and I have a new song. This is like the first single off Pins and Needles. You know, I'm from Nashville, Tennessee, and I was born and raised in the music business, and you know, it's a strange business, but you meet some really great people that you absolutely love, and they're everything that you hoped they would be. And then you meet some people who are not, and they're, you know, they can be total jerks and whatever. I was lucky. I grew up under the Amy Grant umbrella. I don't know if you guys know who Amy Grant is. If you don't, you should. But she was an amazing artist. She still is, and she's just one of the kindest human beings. And being around her all the time, I would just really judge other people by their behavior. And so it was nice having her as a role model. And but anyways, I wrote this song with my good friend Aaron Ray Tier, who also has a record coming out, and Jeff Trott, who has written a bajillion hits with Sheryl Crow. And this song is called Heroes.
When I think heroes, I think capes, chasing villains, stopping trains, half incredible, half insane, What if Superman, he couldn't fly, and Spider-Man, he couldn't climb? What if they're just like you and I?
I did a video for that song too, by the way, and I loved it. It was this girl that I used to babysit. Her name is Sophia Lauer, and she's amazing. She does all these amazing videos. She shot for Kacey Musgraves' new record, and I was like, this is so weird. I'm like, I used to babysit you, now you're doing my first video. Which, by the way, I just so you know, this is all really special to me because I am 44 years old and I am putting out like this record that I've always wanted to put out, which is a 1997-1998 record. And I'm going to take this time to introduce the man, the sound behind everything. He played everything, pretty much everything. Actually, no, Dan Needham played drums as well. And help me out, Greg Lease and Chuck Lavelle. Such a wonderful legend. But this is my husband, Mike Ruckey. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Mike, this is the world. And yeah. And then on drums, we have Mr. Jacob Arnold. I'm my wonderful friend, yep. And also on bass, Shay Wooten. And we're happy to be here today playing for you guys. Also, I don't know if you guys have allergies up there in Philadelphia, but this is usually where this would be filmed, so that's why I'm saying that. But we have a punch bowl down here in Nashville, and I'm telling you, it's fighting me today, but you know what? It ain't gonna win, so... this next song I'm going to play you is a song I wrote with my friend Daniel Tashin and my friends, Daniel Tashin, Rosie Galan. And I was going through a really rough time and basically kind of ghosted Rosie for like 3 months and didn't call her back because I just didn't want to drag her in my drama. And she finally was like, I finally talked to her and she's like, I want to write a song with you called Radio Silence. And I was like, okay, let's do it. So this sounds like I'm talking to someone else, but really the song is about me. And I've vowed never to ghost her again. So this is called Radio Silence.
You don't put love to
very nice, very nice. Funny little story about Rosie, I have to tell you. She actually went to New York, and she had to take a flight there going home, and basically, they had to make an emergency landing, and so every time she would fly, she would call me, and I would be like, she'd be like, will you please pray for me? And I would say, yes. Oh my, I'd write her out this whole long paragraph about how she's my friend, I'm going to pray for her, I'm going to set my alarm, and basically, at the end of this paragraph, I wrote, I love you and you'll be okay, my dead friend. And I have fat fingers and I literally mistyped. I meant to write my dear friend and I wrote my dead friend. But anyways, so that describes me in a nutshell. So anyways, this next song I wrote with my good friends, Sonny Sweeney and Joanna Janae. And by the way, if you're wondering if I'm throwing out all the writers' names, writers here in Nashville are so important to our culture. And you know what? It doesn't matter. You can be an amazing artist, but if you've got crap songs, it doesn't even matter. So, but I'm going to tell you everybody who's written on these songs. But anyways, we wrote this song kind of about the music business, but we've made it more in the corporate world, if you will. But the best thing to know about when you work with a lot of people is just to mind your own business. So, but this is called The Hardest Part About Business.
When the talk is cheap and the secretary sleeping with the boss again, he doesn't know it, but in less than a week he's gonna leave it all from the government. Knowledge is key, but if you're like me, you wish you didn't know the truth. Damned if you do, fired if you don't, and dead if you think it's you. Please over the executive drinking, there's an operator getting busy with a new guy who's always singing. At the end, you will office parties. Well, hear no evil, but you're gonna see. It's better if you work alone. Cause the hardest part about business is finding your own. Automatically makes you guilty as a cat hanging out the back. The more you know it, the more they plead. The fifth, the more they're gonna stab you in the back. Well, you can't win, but if you join them, it's what you're gonna turn into. A tall tale recruiter spreading the rumors till they turn around and pin it on you. In the dark, 'cause you don't have to worry about keeping it in. Please over the executive drinking, there's an operator getting busy with that new guy who's always singing at the annual office parties. Well, hear no evil, but you're gonna see. It's better if you work alone. 'Cause the heart.
right. I'm not sure. Did I say your name earlier? I said this is my husband. This is Mike Recky, my husband. So, sorry, I can't remember. He's just my husband. So to me, but we're gonna also, you know, I wanted to tell you. I forgot to tell you this, but I am a member of the High Women group with Amanda Shires, Brandi Carlile, Maren Morris, and that was such a fun and exciting adventure to go on. I don't know, it just took a detour of my life that I never expected, and we got to do a lot of really fun things. But if I look familiar to you, like, I'm like, you know, I'm like Tito Jackson or something. But okay, we're going to play you one more song. And I wrote this song with my friend Kelly Archer and my good friend Miranda Lambert. This song is, we wrote it a while back ago, and, you know, it was one of those songs that didn't work for Miranda, but it sure worked for me. And so I snagged it and put it on this little, on Pins and Needles. And anyways, it just talks about the relationship between two crazy people. And I feel like that's her and I in a nutshell. And also Kelly, she's hilarious. But this is our last song we're going to play you, and we so appreciate you having us and listening to us from Bulgaria and all over the globe, really. And yeah, hopefully you come out and see us play sometime. Thank you so much. This is called It Takes One. Ask for forgiveness, never permission. Live a life that's gonna kill you anyway. Beggars can't be choosers, I beg to differ. I choose to beg for a love this pain can make, holding us separate. Baby, if you're desperate, I'm the absolute. Full disclosure, never a poser. Having you with us, and we hope to come back and play for you again someday. Hope y'all have a great day.